Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video, I want to use the payment function to calculate a house loan or mortgage. Okay, so I was just working on a car loan calculator using the payment function, and to do this for a mortgage is similar, very, very similar. And in fact, if you want, you can download the file, there's a link in the video description, or just open up Excel and create your own. It's very easy to do. So I've got my car loan calculator off to the side, but I'm going to go past that and just kind of pretend, starting from scratch here. And for my mortgage calculator, I need to know a few things, kind of like I did for a car. I certainly need to know the house price. Need to know my down payment. And then that is going to leave my loan amount. So put down a down payment, borrow the rest. I also need to know the number of years for the loan. Mortgages, house loans are generally expressed in years. I need to know my interest rate. And then that's going to help me determine what my monthly payment is. My monthly payment. And of course, after the monthly payment, I always like to know what the total paid is and the cost of finance. How much extra did I have to pay because I borrowed the money instead of paying for it all at once? So with the house price, we'll go ahead and put down a number. I live in a kind of a high house price area. So I'm going to put in $350,000. My down payment, I'm going to go ahead and put down $45,000. The loan amount, don't do the math in your head, it's going to be equal to the price of the house minus the down payment. That's what you have to borrow to get the house. Now, house loans are usually expressed in maybe 30-year intervals, 15-year intervals. I'm going to start off with a 30-year interval, and I can see that my number is getting formatted as a percent, so I'm just going to change that over to comma style, and then I'll just type in my 30 again, and there we go. So don't forget, you put in some numbers, if they don't get formatted the way you want, then you can just alter the formatting. Doesn't mean you made a mistake, okay? In fact, I will reduce some decimals on there. Now my interest rate, I'm going to go ahead and put down 3.9% for the interest rate. Now I want Excel to calculate the monthly payment. So I type in an equal sign to start off my function. Type in the PMT, opening parentheses, and now I'm going to use my arguments. Kind of like before, I only need the first three arguments or parameters of this particular function. The rate is going to, I'm going to click on the cell that contains my annual rate and divide that by 12 to get a monthly rate, comma. For number of payments per year, or I'm sorry, total number of payments. This is going to need a little formula too, or a calculation at least. I'm going to click on the cell that contains the number of years and multiply it by 12 because I need the total number of months. So 30 times 12 is 360. So really I need a 360 here, but I don't want to type in the 360 because I want to be able to change the number of years from 30 to 15 and things like that. Comma, and now for my present value, I'm going to do a minus sign, a negative version of the loan amount. And putting that minus sign in there is going to give me a monthly payment displayed in positive numbers. So annual rate divided by 12, number of years times 12, negative version of the loan amount. That's my payment calculation. So for this house, $350,000. 45 down, I have to borrow $305,000 at 30 years at 3.9%. The monthly payment for this house is $1,438.59, and that is accurate. So the total paid is going to be equal to my monthly payment times the number of years I paid it times 12, because I had to pay it each month of those 30 years, and I'm going to add all of that to my down payment. So the total paid for this $350,000 house, $562,000. The cost of finance is going to be the total paid minus the original price of the thing. So $212,000. And of course, that excess is what you had to pay since you borrowed the money. Now, I'm a big fan of the Dave Ramsey personal finance radio show, and of course his advice is never get a 30-year mortgage, instead go for the 15-year mortgage. So watch this. When I change this 30 to a 15, make a note of what happens to the cost of finance. From 30 to 15, I go from $212,000 to less than $100,000. So you're saving over $115,000 just by doing a 15-year mortgage instead of a 30-year mortgage. Now, of course, that makes your monthly payment go up, but you're saving a bunch of money in the long run. So that's what's nice about using Excel in order to make these kinds of calculators, because then you can do little what-if scenarios. And maybe that $2,200 is just a little bit too much. Well, then that means you either got to dial back on the house price or you got to raise the down payment. So maybe instead of a $350,000 house, maybe I can find one for $300,000. And that will reduce the payment. Or maybe instead of buying it in a couple years when I can save up $45,000, maybe I buy it in 4 years when I can save up $80,000. So I can make a bigger down payment, which means I borrow less, which means that monthly payment gets a little bit smaller. So don't forget the payment function for a mortgage, similar to a car. However, I still take my annual rate divided by 12 to get a monthly rate. And then since house loans are often expressed in years, I take the number of years and multiply it by 12 still to get the total number of months. And then of course I do my negative version of the loan amount. That accurately calculates the payment for a mortgage. So go ahead and create your own calculator and start to figure out exactly what the monthly payments would be for a particular house given the cost and down payment. Take care.